With Hashem's loving grace, welcome to Emuna Beams with your host, Laser Brody. Today's episode is entitled, All for the Best. Once, when Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi encountered Elijah the prophet, he asked Elijah if he could accompany him so that he could learn from his conduct. Elijah refused, explaining that Rabbi Yeshua would not understand what he would see. On the contrary, his mortal mind would raise countless questions and there would be no time for explanations. Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi begged and pleaded. He promised that he would not ask any questions. Elijah finally agreed on the condition that if Rabbi Yeshua would begin to ask questions, they would part company. So they set out together. Toward evening, they reached an old hut. An elderly couple was sitting outside. They were obviously poor, but their poverty did not hamper their enthusiasm to welcome guests. As soon as they saw the travelers, they jumped up and eagerly invited them into their home, offering them a meal and a place to sleep. The accommodations were somewhat lacking because the people did not have very much, but whatever they had, they willingly shared, doing the very best they could to observe the mitzvah of hachnasas orchim, giving hospitality to guests. The following morning, the two travelers bade their host farewell and set out again. Shortly after they departed, Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi saw that Elijah was praying. He listened closely. What was Elijah praying for? The elderly couple who had hosted them owned a cow. The cow was the most valuable possession they owned. Indeed, the majority of their income came from the cow's milk. Elijah was praying that the cow should die. When Rabbi Yeshua heard this, he was shocked. The couple had been so kind, so pleasant, and so warm. Why did they deserve that their cow should die? But he couldn't ask any questions because that was the agreement. And they proceeded on their journey, and Rabbi Yeshua hoped that Elijah would offer an explanation for what happened. But that was not the case. Toward evening, they came to a beautiful mansion. Although many members of the household saw them, no one offered them hospitality. They asked the owner of the house, a very wealthy man, for permission to spend the night. Reluctantly, the man agreed, but he was very cold to them. He did not offer them any food, and he hardly said a word to them. And they set out on their way in the morning. Rabbi Yeshua noticed that Elijah was praying again. What was he praying for this time? Well, one of the walls of the rich man's house was cracked and weak. Elijah was praying to Hashem that the wall should be restored and should remain strong and solid. Well, Rabbi Yeshua could not understand. This person had not acted kindly toward them, yet Elijah was praying to Hashem on his behalf. Once more, he abided by the terms of the agreement, and he didn't ask any questions. Eventually, the two travelers arrived in a beautiful city. Everything about the place reflected prosperity and opulence. They made their way to the synagogue. It was a magnificent structure, designed with elegance and good taste. Everything, even the benches, were beautiful. Rabbi Yeshua thought that he would have no problem receiving hospitality in such a town, but it didn't work that way. The people were not very kind. When their prayers were over, nobody approached the two travelers to ask them where they planned to eat or where they planned to sleep. Ultimately, they had to spend the night in the synagogue without eating supper. In the morning, when they were ready to leave, Elijah blessed the inhabitants of the city, wishing that they should all become leaders. Again, Rabbi Yeshua was puzzled. Why did Elijah bless people who had not shown them hospitality? That evening they came to another city. It was not as wealthy a community as the first. The synagogue was nowhere near as beautiful, but the people were very fine and warm and kind. They did everything they could to make the two travelers comfortable. But before leaving the city, Elijah told them, "May Hashem help that only one of you becomes a leader." At that point, Rabbi Yeshua could no longer contain his curiosity. He told Elijah, "I know that by asking, I will forfeit my right to accompany you, but I can't go on like this. Please explain these four incidents to me." And so Elijah began to explain. The elderly couple, whom we met first, were wonderful people who always performed acts of kindness. It was destined for the woman to pass away that day. So I had to pray that their cow, which meant so much to them, and there was a source of income, should replace the woman, and she should be taken instead of the woman, and instead the woman received another two decades. About the wealthy person's home, in that wall, a great treasure lay buried, but the wall was weak and would soon break, and because he was a miserly person and conducted himself so rudely, I prayed that the homeowner should not discover the treasure, and the wall should become strong, that he would not be able to benefit from it. Elijah continued to answer Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi's questions. He said, "My prayer was they should all become leaders in the city. That's not a blessing. If anything, it's the opposite. The most destructive thing that can happen to a city is that everyone becomes a leader." And in the other city, where the people were kind, I gave them a genuine blessing that they should only have one true leader, and that way they'll be unified behind it. We learn from this story that we can't understand at all what we see. The Gemara tells us that Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi was one of the 9 Tzaddikim who went straight into Gan Eden without tasting a physical death. That's how pure he was. Even so, he had trouble understanding what Elijah the prophet was doing in accordance with divine wisdom that dictated his actions. Now, if a tremendous tzaddik like Yeshua ben Levi couldn't understand what Hashem was doing by way of Elijah, we can't possibly presume to understand divine wisdom. So what do? As soon as understanding kicks out, Emuna kicks in. Even if something seems bad, intrinsically it's really good because it's coming from a loving Father in heaven who does everything for the very best. So put a smile on your face, be happy, and God bless always.